What's up, everybody? My name is Gabe. I'm 25 years old, and I had porn-induced ED for 9 months-ish. And this video is just gonna be all the advice I can give and any suggestions I can give to any of y'all that are trying to recover from porn-induced ED or any other porn-induced sexual dysfunction. These are things that worked for me, and I'm just gonna share them, and hopefully they'll work for y'all. And at the end of the day, you can take it or leave it. It's just advice. My first piece of advice is to learn everything you can about pornography addiction. And learn that addiction is about brains and not about substance. In the past decade, we've learned that you can be addicted to just about anything as long as your brain perceives it as rewarding. It's not about the chemicals you put in your body, but addiction is really about whether or not your brain has changed. And all addictions share some of the same main brain changes. Some big words to throw at y'all is sensitization, which means your brain creates kind of a neural, think Pavlov's dog, a neural highway to a reward. And then that makes you really want to crave that reward. And then desensitization, which is just a numbed pleasure response to all things pleasurable, which basically means life seems boring and the only thing that seems rewarding is that highway that you created for your addiction. And then hypofrontality, which actually is right here in the frontal lobes. They become smaller and the signal of, wait a minute, we should think about this, becomes weaker. And all addictions share those same brain changes. When I first realized I couldn't get an erection without pornography, I started Googling like crazy. I found a great website. Everyone needs to check it out if you haven't already checked it out. www.yourbrainonporn.com. And it has everything you need to know about pornography addiction, rebooting, and other guys' stories and advice for y'all. I would start with the Start Here article, and then after you read that, that'll give you a basic understanding of what's happened. Go to the Frequently Asked Questions or the FAQ tab up at the top and just read everything on there and go over it and over it and over again until you really understand the concepts and you already know all the questions that guys always ask, and we have everything that we know is already on there. Gary Wilson and his wife Marnia did a great job with that website. So go there, read it, and soak it in. Alright, now that you learned everything and you've hopefully made a decision to quit porn for good, you need to change your environment. One of the first things I did was I went in my room and I got my laptop. I took it out in the backyard and I smashed it on the ground and set it on fire. No, I'm just kidding, I didn't do that. But what I did do is took my laptop into the living room to a place more public where I wouldn't be tempted to, you know, surf the internet all night. I had a huge problem with just getting on Facebook and creeping and wasting tons of time. I didn't move my laptop into the living room because I was tempted to watch porn, really. The main reason I did it was because I saw a study one time where cocaine addicts were shown pictures of cocaine or things related to their addiction, and their brain still lit up some of those same addicted pathways. And since I was rebooting, you know, I want to cut off all addiction pathways in my brain so they can wither away and weaken. So I didn't want my brain to fire up anything just seeing my laptop next to my bed where I used to, you know, go to town. I would encourage y'all to move it to at least, if you have a laptop or whatever, move it somewhere more public, or maybe don't even get on the internet at all unless you're either around other people or in public. I stopped watching TV unless I was with family or friends or, you know, the occasional big sports game or something. I cut out watching most R-rated movies, or at least beforehand I would make sure that it didn't have a sex scene in it or any kind of porno scene, because I didn't want my brain to fire up those same pathways when I was recovering. I remember one time I started a movie and literally the first scene was a sex scene. I gave up Facebook. I had a big problem with sitting there just surfing the web, wasting time. And I'd rather, during my reboot, I wanted to talk to people face to face. I threw away all my magazines. I'd be looking through them and they were just filled with sexual ads. And I found myself doing more looking and less reading. I also cut out the radio. When I was recovering, I was so depressed, and every single song on mainstream radio was sex this, sex that, and all these songs just really pissed me off. I realized it was just better to just cut that out altogether. When you're recovering from addiction, it's a lot easier when you don't have your addiction sitting right in front of your face. So get rid of everything you have associated with it, whatever that is. If it's DVDs, magazines, saved files on your computer, or maybe even your device if you need to for a little bit. You don't have to do it forever, but while you're rebooting, it might be smart to, you know, give it to a friend, let someone borrow it. Drastic times call for drastic measures. Porn fantasy is something you want to stay away from too. When you think about something, your brain lights up some of the same pathways that would light up when you actually do something. So it's best to stay away from all fantasy during a reboot. We're not really sure how thinking about real girls affects your reboot, but in my opinion, fantasizing at all is probably not a good idea, because when you've wired your brain to porn from a young age, everything you have in your mind is porn related, so it's pretty hard to imagine a sex scene or anything sexual without having some kind of porn influence creep in. So I'd stay away from all fantasy. Okay, now that you got rid of everything associated with your addiction, you need to fill the void that's there with replacement activities. They need to be something that's fun, active, and productive. Things that I did was I started playing basketball again, because I quit when I was younger. When I was about 17, 18, I was really into basketball. I wanted to play in college, but I quit pretty much because I was hooked on sex, video games, and porn. And I also got back into school, started working towards my degree. I started reading books, trying to just learn everything I could about as much as I could. I also started taking my dog to the park and just really enjoying being outside. And she likes to catch the frisbee, so I started, you know, going and playing with her all the time. And while I was there, sometimes I would hit a little park workout, which leads me to the other thing I did that was huge, was I started working out a lot. I started going to the gym some more, and I got really into fitness. I actually am working on my personal trainer certification now, and I have my own boot camp class. Another good thing to do is to start playing a musical instrument.
In my spare time, I like to play the pianos.
I got a new job working with teenagers. I really didn't like the job I had, so I wanted to get something more rewarding. And now I'm working with kids, trying to be like a big brother type figure to them. And while I'm there, I actually teach them all about pornography addiction and its effects on the brain, as well as social media and just being on the internet in general. The bottom line though is just stop sitting inside pouting and being depressed all the time. Be proactive about it. You gotta fill that void with something healthy. So get outside, live, laugh, and love, and enjoy life. The next step is to prepare for withdrawal. Some common withdrawal symptoms when you give up porn would be anxiety, depression, brain fog, lack of concentration, loss of libido, which is called flatline. I know me personally, about a month, maybe 2 months in, withdrawal symptoms hit me hard. I was real depressed. One day at work, I had an anxiety attack. I ran outside into the alley and started just freaking out, kicking boxes. I like laid on the ground, my muscles were shaking, my whole body was freaking out. I was pretty much just losing my mind. So just be aware that that can happen and be prepared for anything. And you got to get to a place where you're willing to go through hell to get to the other side and know that there's hope and know that there is light at the end of the tunnel. And other guys have been through it before. I was borderline suicidal when I was depressed, and I made it out just fine. I'm here smiling right now. And you can too. Just keep on trucking and know that they're gonna come. It's not easy. The next step is to get support. I would encourage y'all to go to a site like yourbrainrebalance.com. It's a whole community where guys are posting their stories, posting their problems, and the whole community is helping each other out. So go do that, make an account free, it can be anonymous, or you could go over to Reddit, subreddit nofap, reddit.com/r/nofap, and there's like 80,000 plus guys over there talking about rebooting and what to do with porn addiction and all their problems. Also, there's tons of success stories on Your Brain Rebalance, nofap, and yourbrainonporn.com that y'all can go read, and just really know that you're not alone. When I first started my reboot, I spent so much time just reading guys' stories so I could, you know, pick bits and pieces of their story that I could relate to mine, and just know that, you know, he went through this pain, he went through the process, and I knew that I could too. So that really helped me. It gave me hope and encouraged me to keep on trucking. I didn't know how long it was going to take for me to recover. Me personally, since I started on porn so young, I started, you know, jacking it at the age of 8. I was using cable TV by 10, and then I was jerking it to high-speed internet porn by 12. So I wired my brain at a young age for porn, so it took me longer to recover because the pathways in my brain were deeper. So I recovered in about 9 months-ish. I would encourage y'all, if you know you're having a long reboot, to not lose hope, to know that some guys have taken longer than me, but they've still recovered, and a lot of guys have taken less time. Just know that everyone that we've seen so far has recovered. If porn's the problem, it's all in your brain, and as we know, your brain can change. So don't worry about how long it's gonna take. Just commit to it, know it's gonna suck, and as far as we know, everyone that's tried to reboot has been able to recover. My last piece of advice, and what I believe is most important, is you gotta get to a place where porn is not an option anymore. I know for me personally, when I realized that porn jacked my brain up so much that I couldn't get turned on by a girl anymore and my wiener didn't work, when I realized girls were no longer humans in my eyes but I could only view them as sex objects, and I no longer had the ability to love or feel love, I was just completely consumed with lust. It was a pretty easy decision for me personally to decide then and there that I was never going to watch porn again. And I was willing to go through hell and go through whatever it took to recover. So I would just strongly encourage y'all to try and get to that mindset. Try and realize that porn will never satisfy you. It'll only lead you to a place where you can't satisfy anyone. And it'll rob all the love and joy that you could ever have in your heart. And it'll just completely desensitize you. So try and get that mindset of porn is not an option anymore. Alright, I hope everything that I just told y'all helps. That's just advice, some suggestions, everything that I just told y'all I experienced or I went through and I tried out. So I hope it helps. Feel free to comment or post any questions or concerns you have. I'd love to make more response videos and answer you guys' questions. And my last piece of advice is just give back to the community. Go make an account. Share your story so other guys can, you know, get inspiration and encouragement from what you guys have to share. Like I said earlier, that's how I recovered. I read other guys' stories and got motivation from them. So you do the same thing. Post your story. Post any experiences you have. Don't be afraid to talk about this. It took me a while to get there, and I know it's not easy, but I finally came clean with all my friends, my girlfriend, my family, and talking to them was super therapeutic. It helped lift that weight off my shoulders, and now I'm not afraid to, you know, go out and talk about it, because this is a problem that way more people than we know about are struggling with. So just don't be afraid to talk about it. Yeah, feel free to hit me up with anything y'all have. Bye.
In my spare time, I like to play the pianos.